I'm Sean with Summit Racing. We hear a lot of questions about torque converters, and we've spent a fair time covering torque converters in some of our past videos. In fact, some of the first videos we ever produced covered how to choose a torque converter, the difference between flash and foot brake stall speeds, and lockup versus non-lockup converters. But what if you've already bought your torque converter and it isn't working properly or won't even install correctly? In this video, we will cover 5 most common problems associated with torque converters and help you diagnose the underlying cause. Before we get started troubleshooting, let's go over a few installation tips to help avoid problems in the first place. First, before you install your new converter, take a pre-measurement for reference purposes to ensure proper engagement of the new torque converter. To do this, place a straight edge across the front mounting surface of the transmission and measure back to the original torque converter. This measurement should be the same with the new torque converter. You will next want to add 1 quart of transmission fluid to help pre-lube the bearings that are inside your new torque converter. You'll also want to replace the transmission filter if you haven't done so already. Also inspect and replace the flex plate at this time as well. Lastly, you should apply transmission fluid to the front seal and be sure to apply grease to the pilot of the torque converter before it's installed into the crankshaft. Now let's focus on troubleshooting some common performance and installation issues. One of the most common problems customers share with us is poor acceleration, which is often the result of low stall speed. Start your troubleshooting process by making sure the torque converter stall range properly matches the camshaft RPM range. General rule of thumb is that the torque converter stall speed should be roughly 500 RPM higher than the starting RPM of the cam. If this isn't the case in your situation, you'll need a different stall speed converter or a new camshaft that matches your current converter. Next, make sure your converter's stall speed is the right match for your vehicle's gear ratio. The numerically higher the gear ratio, the lower the flash stall. Typically, a 342 or higher gear ratio will require a higher stall speed, so you may need a different converter to match. You should also factor in the weight of your vehicle. The lighter the vehicle, the lower the stall speed will end up being, and vice versa. Again, consider switching to a converter with a higher stall speed if you have a light vehicle. Another area to look at is engine torque. This has a drastic effect on stall speed. For example, a torque converter will stall roughly 300 to 500 RPM higher behind a big block than a small block. That's because engines that produce more low-end torque usually bump the stall speed up in the RPM range. Take a look at your engine and torque output and determine if you've got the right stall speed. According to B&M, the stall speed should be rated about 500 to 750 RPM under your engine's peak torque RPM. If you don't know your exact peak torque RPM, be conservative. If you overestimate this, you may select a converter with too low of a stall speed. What if your vehicle seems slower than it used to be? This is often caused by a stall speed that's too high. In this case, the rules we covered for low stall speed apply in reverse. Go back through what we covered earlier and consider where your car or truck fits in with those parameters. Sometimes the converter will fit too tightly against the flex plate. If you're running up against this problem, make sure the torque converter is fully seated on the input shaft of the transmission. In most cases, you'll need to feel 3 clicks of engagement before it's properly seated. The first 2 clicks, which is the engagement on the input shaft, usually occur easily, and many people make the mistake of thinking that the converter is fully seated at this point. However, there's a 3rd click that must happen, which is the pump drive. If necessary, you may have to remove the transmission and reinstall the torque converter to ensure proper engagement on the input shaft. Now, if you've made the pre-measurement mentioned earlier during our installation tips, matching this measurement with your new torque converter will confirm that you've installed it correctly. Oftentimes, a customer will say, "I can't get the converter to engage on the input shaft." In this case, we'll start the troubleshooting process by stating the converter must be installed on the transmission before the transmission is installed into the vehicle. However, if the converter will not slide on easily, try working the converter up and down on the input shaft, spinning it in the process. Often, smaller converters are harder to install because there's less room for the internal parts to move. This causes alignment problems with the input shaft, but a little patience usually pays off. Finally, what if your torque converter went bad prematurely? Start by looking at your vehicle's gear ratio. If you choose a high stall converter to go with a numerically low gear, the converter can overheat and fail. That's because the torque converter likely never reached its stall point at cruising RPM. You'll need to replace the converter and install a numerically higher gear set that will make the cruise RPM higher than the stall rating of the converter. we'd also ask that you make sure the torque converter was never installed on a transmission that has previously failed. It is possible that debris from the failed transmission may have traveled through the converter and damaged it. Lastly, did you use a transmission cooler with your new converter? For higher stall converters, say 2500 RPM and above, a transmission cooler should always be used to ensure proper fluid cooling. And there you have it, the 5 most common torque converter troubleshooting questions we hear, and the roadmap to solving the problems. Thanks for watching.